first is just around the belly, all right? Take the cover of your left hand, feed it in. Hold it tight, get that hooked up. When you get hooked up, drive your knee down. You take your belt, palm up. When you get another foot up, move your knee back to the arm. If you're going to trap it, that's just fine. If you're not going to trap, you're going to feel okay. Just push this arm down here.
Worldwide, they call it T-Lock. I
difficult to reduce. The other method is, you know, how do you turn the water around? The turn. From all holes, there is enough of the turn, or two or three, and brick and roll, or two or three. The sit-ups are variations of the brick and roll, because the body is on the floor. So, just let's take one. I'm a little kid. Take that arm, guess what? You don't go.
Yeah.
You go. You saw that thing in the top of somebody, maybe a little bit difficult, throwing the pushy, and the other guy hit the mat. Pops out just like this, back up. He's with this. So, he's trapped his arm. I Pressure and regulatory cuts right there on the thymus. And the thymus sends a signal to the brain to say, we got a lot of pressure. We don't need any more pressure up here. And the heart slows down at the very time when it should be trying to struggle and get blood past your blockage to the brain. So you see false signals. The brain's heart rate should be pumping like mad, and it slows down because you're pressing on the thymus. That's why you press the thymus. If you press below the thymus, the sinus isn't getting the pressure, you're cutting it off. The sinus will tell the heart, keep going, pump up. And then the pumping will increase. So you want to press right under the jaw with this muscle, first muscle, pointer. And then the little finger knuckle presses against the side of the larynx. Now the larynx is a voice box. It's very simple. If I press with my finger like this, you can very uncomfortable. Here's that hell. So you want to press against the larynx with that little finger knuckle while you're pressing against the parotid sinus with the pointer knuckle. And if you have that position correctly and you snap it on, that should be very, very, very effective. Scares him because it presses on the side of the larynx. It cuts off the blood because it's on the parotid sinus that he is doing. That's how quick the whole thing. So, now here's how you can. You get your vital cell inside, same old thing, feed the thing in, get it up. Then you put your fingers inside. And the secret is that you have to run your hand down around till it's almost in front of you. And I'm right on it now. Now, Ron used to soak them right there. Put them out right there. Push. People turn their face away from it. They'll drive this hand. Take this hand and drive it straight out. Drive it hard. He knocks my hand up behind him, holding on the back of the head. So it's not always a good idea to try to kill the deer, although you can use the first. What the white does to prevent him from defending himself is what a lot of us teach is to pull him up. You bring this knee up close and pull him up. And then you take this leg and wrap it around. And you wrap it around underneath you. And then you pull him up. In that direction, I'll get it right. Tap out when you really have it. Find the bell inside. When you're feeding, your hand is in there, huh? Look, my hand's in there. And you can get in the habit of sliding that knee very quickly. Pull him up, swing around, and now he's out. Leave the fingers in, slide right around. Pull him up, swing him right around. Far up on the side. Thank you. selling side. Pull him up. Wrist drag. On selling side. Pull him up. Wrist drag from behind. Hold your bind behind. Your hand goes in from behind, from the back side, from his foot side. You don't go like this. You go from behind. I know you didn't hear me, so I'll say it again. You go from behind to get his wrist from the back. This way. You don't go from the front. You go from the back. That's going to be your big problem. Say, right, Cole. Go from the back. Reach him and get his wrist. When you get his wrist, push with your elbow on his upper arm. Push with your elbow and push it down. Get your shoulder on the floor. Lay it on the open shoulder. Use your arm to the belt. Bend our arm to the finished shoulder. The shoulder to mobilize the shoulder. Follow the other side. Pull him up. Grab from behind. Get the wrist lock. Pull through. unfortunate situation, and then they go 51. It doesn't seem kind of when you have an opportunity, all of you have. You're not using that. That's it. That's it. The people. You don't want to earn our position, you don't have to have that. That's right. Or that's not. No, no. That's the other side. taken for them. Then, you need to get on the ground, all the way around his body, all the way around.
breathing perfect. But it makes him feel uncomfortable in hell, and he forgets about getting out. He's worried. My head? So, Jesus says this one-hand grip is the strongest grip in the universe. For now. You're under his shoulder and on his belt, and you're pressing into his elbow with his head, and at the same time, as you pull in with all your force, and you've got tremendous muscular strength. So, if this was your side, you'd pull it. Thank you.
maintain the correct position with reference to the board and the water.
When they enter the water, what do they do in the position they use?
That's a kinesthetic word. And you know we have a simple kinesthetic word. Move always in such a way that your body will never come to you. It will never come to you. Move in that way, always. Down on the mat and he goes, help. He's helpful. He's such a good actor, you say. He's helpful. It's like the hunters that throw that wounded animal call. Predators see him. That's the way he was. And he does. Help hunters, you know. He's very good at that. He sucks you in. Often the enemy is the lure. Right. The art of war. total does not count until the other guy taps out. If he doesn't tap out, you have zero. You can't kill me. Of course you can't kill me. I have to. What do I do? No one can talk back to the
referee. Are you going to let him do that to me?
Where he has strength, boy. Pretty much extreme for him now. Far from a lower meaning strike. Anger is generally all the world. Then we have fun today. We have a brain game. We watch out. Not really good. When you make the nice technique, it gets fun. When you win, you win. Got it. Sit on his head, David. And this way.
Do it fast or do it slow? We're practicing fast.
Sure.
See, we're going to go ahead. Would you like to cross his head and put it in the air?
Fast. Far leg and far ankle.
Okay.
doesn't find it. Okay? You by side, get ready. One guy down, one guy up. Fire leg all around. Go. Come back up quick.
Yeah, but wait for the legs to go by, and then
I have to talk to you very long there. My
turn back to you on the ground.
They'd rather have that than around. around your whole body. You'll never get that damn thing off sometimes.
I'll show you how. It's foolish.
But don't get it. Get through your heels. Then, if he doesn't have this leg moving, it's just here, then you're in.
Still tight. You get here. We'll hold your leg.
Hold you. Can't get that leg out. Now you can get away from that problem of having to entangle your back leg by putting your back leg in first. It's called crossing, not the book. But it'll be an update. So here, this way, shift your weight a little. Hey, Mark Johnson. So you tie those two. Knee in and cross knee in. Knee in the back leg. And cross knee in. Just a couple of times, you can. Patrick. You were wondering if you were going to get any trouble today, weren't you? Exactly. Use your fist towards the knee now. Not back leg out. Ah, you're back. Smart as you know. Very good. What you did first, that's what I'm going to say. The other is to do cross knee. That is, you stay still on this knee and you pull your knee to this way. You come to the cable and you turn. That's cross knee. And the other is just saying, that's what you did out of old you like. You throw your feet up in the air and come around. So you can either pancake around, flat down all the way, or you can back leg, or you can cross knee. Think of those terms, but you use them not only in this particular instance, but you use them in many cases. Back leg, cross knee, and pancake around. Okay? Now, go back and do it. Knee in and back leg. Knee in and then back leg. Then cross knee. That's cross knee. Good. That's cross knee. All right. You cross knee. Trick is not over. Trick is never over. Life never quits, you know? You don't drive skill to something and get killed on the other day. That's not the way to do the game of life. That's the game of skill. When you're on the field, that you never roll over on your back. Never, 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 never roll over on your back. Practicing how to move. Do that. You don't do it. You do the drill and skill is not. Not enough. Ring block. front waffle. Go ahead. Pop. Put your feet down. Turn over on your feet. Thank you. walk right over. One foot to walk right over, like walk down the bottom. Step up to the right. Oh, that's the climb. You do that. If you come up with both feet on the mat in the same way, it's a front hand press. If you come up with walk through, round off the left. Round off the throw. Flip up.